What is going on, guys? And I'm really excited because remember the last video that we posted last week about the ZV-1 from Sony? Maybe for the first time, Sony, it is going to re-engineer this screen to really flip from the side rather from the top. We talked about some of the rumors and we talked about some of the predictions that we thought this camera was going to have. Guess what? I think we were spot on a lot of the things, and right now, Sony has actually leaked a video. So we can actually see the camera right now. This is indeed a brand new camera, and this falls right about the time where Sony is supposed to release the new RX100 Mark VIII. So we have some rumors also confirmed by the guys at Alpha Rumor. Thank you for the knowledge there always. And we're gonna talk about that right now. Now, one of the things right off the bat that we can see, and one of the things that we actually talked about, was that we were saying that in order for this camera to be a dedicated vlogging camera, would have to have a flip to the side type of screen so you can actually mount stuff on the top of the camera. Guess what? This is exactly what we can see right here in this picture. We do have a flip to the side screen, and this is something that Sony should have done long time ago. Finally, we're having here. So, flip out screen. Now, what else we have actually talked about? Well, we talked about Sony engineering a microphone, an onboard microphone that actually can work for the camera, and you don't really have to rely on external gear. So, as you can see in the first picture, it looks like we have a dead cat on the top of the camera, and then from the top shot, we actually see a square surface is as wide as the camera. It's about 3.5 centimeters, something like that, and it has felt. So indeed, this is a flat microphone that Sony had re-engineered, perhaps a flat shotgun microphone. And for the first time, we may actually have great quality audio in a camera without actually having to rely on external gear. So, this is exactly what it looks like it is, and I'm pretty excited to really know if this is the case, because if that's the case, can you imagine vlogging with a camera that you don't have to hook anything up? Everything you need is right there on the camera. Okay, and the other thing that we can see in this picture is that we have a hot shoe mount. And a hot shoe mount, it is actually incredible because you are going to be able to use, if you want better quality and you're not satisfied with the audio, a microphone like this one. Now, this is the microphone that I use in my A6600 when I vlog. And the reason why I love this microphone is the connection happens from the bottom of the shoe. So we're no longer are going to need to actually plug cable and have things dangling around. What else we talked about in the other video? Well, remember that we talked about Sony potentially adding additional buttons for the camera. And when you're talking about vlogging, it makes a lot of sense because all the buttons on the camera are on the back, you know, aside from the power button and the shutter release button. Now, we can see in this picture, we have newer buttons. The first button that actually sticks out right here is the movie record button. Finally, we have a dedicated movie record button that is actually almost as big as the shutter release button. And this one, instead of protrude out, it looks like it actually is sunken in, so you can actually feel it with a finger and never be wrong with it. And the other thing that we talked about in the other video, when I was actually showing my RX100 from the top, we actually showed a spot that would have been ideal for a button. And actually, I'm gonna play that video right now. Right here, to actually put a new button in this area. Right over there. And actually having a new button right there can be really useful to change your white balance or to change your focusing mode. So actually that happens to be the C1 button that at the same time is fairly large and it has a mountain and a person. So this can only mean one thing, that this button may be the auto object detect. And we talked about that. This is something that we also spoke in the last video when we brought up some of the rumors. So, what is auto object detect? Well, it makes a lot of sense for a vlogging camera to really have a feature that can actually ignore stuff around and really focus on the guy that's telling the story, in this case, yourself, the vlogger. And how many times we have actually ruined vlogs by, you know, thinking we're in focus and all of a sudden like a car passes by and the camera starts tracking the car in the back or a tree or stuff like that. So the auto object detect feature may be something that, you know, you press it and the camera tells you ignore anything else but you or focus on moving objects and stuff like that. So Really good thing to have for a vlogging camera, because remember, when we're vlogging, we must focus on the story and how many times we are so nervous of things going out of whack and, you know, the image going out of focus, the audio not being perfect and stuff like that. So this camera, it is going to have a lot of artificial intelligence to really control the picture at all times. And this may be the perfect camera, Mr. Camera Conspiracy. I really love your videos, by the way.
All I want is the perfect camera.
But this may be the perfect vlogging camera, to be honest with you. Now, another thing that we also mentioned in our last video is that, you know, in order to vlog, you need to have a wider lens. And the 24 to 200 millimeter f2.8 to 4.5, it's not gonna cut it. So what are some of the things that we need when we're vlogging? Well, we need a wide angle lens and we need some background separation. And the 2.8 to 4.5, it is not going to cut it. Now, it is confirmed that this camera is going to have a 24 to 70 millimeter f1.8 to 2.8. Now, am I really excited? Well, it's kind of like better than the one that we have right now, that is actually 24 200 f2.8 to 4.5. And on the RX 100 Mark 7, you know, the 2.8 is for a split moment, and the moment you zoom out, you already are in the 3, 3.5, and the 4.5. So what I think, I hope Sony is gonna deliver instead of the 24 to 70, it's a 16 to 50. And this is something that we also rumored before and speculated before. We were saying that perhaps this is going to be an f1.4. Now, imagine having in a tiny camera that now you have flip out screen, you have an onboard microphone that you can use, and you have actually a really wide aperture lens that is wide. This could be the perfect camera of all time. I mean, at least the perfect vlogging camera of all time. So we also talked about the sensor, and we were saying when we actually talked about the RX 100 Mark 8, okay? We weren't even talking about a dedicated vlogging camera, that the sensor, we may see some resolution bump, but it is confirmed that this is going to be a 20 megapixel sensor, 1 inch. And 20 megapixel sensor, when it comes to video, makes a lot of sense. You know, you want to have smaller pixels, bigger pixels for better low light capabilities. Now, I'm sure that this sensor is also going to be a brand new version of the current sensor that the RX 100 Mark 7 uses for several reasons. Number one, we may have a new processor that is going to have also better capabilities. And this sensor may be able to do better things such as, you know, autofocus tracking, and, you know, utilize a lot of those features that we mentioned before, like the object auto detect. So probably there's a lot of technology here working in combination processor, lens, and sensor all together to really give you those automated control in your camera and make sure that you always are in focus and the story is exactly the way you want it to be. Now, we also, obviously, we're gonna have all the autofocus modes that we have in the RX 100 Mark 7, probably the latest autofocus that we have in the A9. Chances are that that's gonna happen. And the announcement is going to happen on May 26th. So that means it's about a week from now. So this camera is going to drop really, really quick. Now, let me take another look at this camera because it just looks exactly what we expected. Now, the last thing that we also talked about in that video was that Sony may also release a grip that has a battery, that has control, and that is going to be specifically designed for this camera. Now, when I talk about specifically designed for this camera, I mean that this control may also connect from the bottom. So no longer we need a cable actually plugged in into the micro USB port. There you go. And basically you're gonna have a wireless, cableless experience from vlogging. Now, this is going to be incredible, and if Sony is able to achieve all this stuff and give you that extra battery life and control through this grip, I can see Sony selling tons of this camera. Now, last but not least, we also mentioned that this camera was going to have USB-C. And at this point, man, you know, everything is USB-C already, you know? What's the reason why, you know, we should see another camera with micro USB? Please, do not put a micro USB. Now, if we have USB-C, we may also have audio monitoring capabilities through a little dongle. And we also talked about that in our last video. That was one of our predictions. So if the camera doesn't have already a headphone jack, because it could probably have already a headphone jack, although the space is really tiny to have like several connectors, chances are that we are gonna have headphone monitoring through USB-C through an adapter. So This may be it, guys. This may be the vlogging camera that everyone has been waiting for, and I'm really excited. What are your thoughts about this camera? Drop your comments down below. Would you be upgrading? So guys, this is it for today. As always, subscribe to the channel if you enjoy the content, and see you later.